Welcome to our YouTube channel Vivekanand Academy of Human Excellence. My name is Komal Veer and I want to ask you one question, which is really very favorite question. That do you like to hear the magical story? Yes, me too. I love to hear magical stories with magical things. And now here we come again with one magical stories from third standard English book, and the story name is The Magic Gift. Now, you ever think that someone give you something and that thing will be magical? If you wear a magic shoes, what will happen with you? If you get a magical pen, what will happen with you? If you get a magical pencil and if you draw a picture and that comes in real, then do you like that thing? Would you like to have magical things with you? Here also there is one boy who got all magical things. And he make his life better with this magical things. Now, what is in the story? We will see it here. But before that, first we will read the story.
Lesson number 5, The Magical Gift. Long ago, a man called Chang lived with his three sons, Yong, Ying, and Chin. Chang was very old and very rich. One day, he called his sons to his bedside. "I want you to make me a promise," he croaked. "When I die, I want you to share my fortune equally. You must live together happily." Chin was glad to agree, but his elder brothers didn't sound so happy. Not long after Chang died, the brothers divided his fortune. "I'm the oldest," said Yong grandly. "I should have the largest share." "I am nearly as old as you," whined Ying. "I deserve a large share too." So Yong and Ying each took a big share of the fortune. "The rest is yours," they told Chin. Chin was left with a tiny bag of silver coins. "Thank you," said Chin. Unlike his greedy brothers, he didn't care for money. Ying, Yong couldn't wait to spend their cash. Soon the house was full of new furniture. "There's no room for you, Chin," said Ying. "You will have to move out." So Chin bought an old hut in the village. His home was simple, but he was happy. He bought them food. Chin spent his days with the poor villagers. He used his money to help them. He bought them food, new clothes, and even paid their rent. He never spent a penny on himself. Meanwhile, Chin's brother used their share of the fortune to make even more money. They bought a huge house, silk clothes, and sparkling jewels. They spent every single penny on themselves. One day, Ying and Yong saw a man dressed in rags. He looked familiar. It was Chin. He had given away all his money and was the poorest man in the village. "You can't go around like that," said Yong. "You are making our family look bad," added Ying. "Leave the village right now," said Yong, "and don't come back until you are rich."
This story started long ago. So here you can see this picture. This person name is Chang. Actually, he is not feeling well. And now he is too old. So he started thinking about himself and he was worried also. So this Chang lived with his three sons. You can see it here. Ying, Yong and Chin. These are three names of his son. So he was living with these three sons, Chin, Yong, Ying. And in this three sons, Yong, this is the oldest one. Then after that, Ying on the second number. And the small one is Chin. One day what happened? Chang, he knew that I am not going to live more now. So he just simply called his three sons at bedtime. When he called his three sons, he said that, "Please, first you make me promise." These three sons started to look at each other, which which promise? Father said, this child said, just promise me, you are my three sons, and after when I die, you will divide this fortune, this money which I have earned. This money you divide into 3 bucks because you are three here, you are three brothers. So divide equally in three. Okay? Because you are brother of each other, so equally you distribute it that. Don't make a small part or the large part of the fortune of my money. Equally you divide that money and live happily together. So as per the wish, everyone they just promised this giant. And Chin agreed with this pen. Chin said, yes, we will sure divide this money, your fortune. Fortune is money. The spelling of fortune is here. F-O-R-T-U-N-E, fortune. It means what? A large amount of money. The money which Chang had earned, that money they are going to divide into 3 parts. And he was very rich. He had a lot of money. So that's why he took that promise from his 3 sons. And his 3 sons agreed with this thing. But after when he died, after the Chang died, all these 3 brothers come together and they again started to live together. But in that, now the oldest one, Yong, said, now this is the time to distribute our money. But I am the oldest one, so I will get a large share of fortune. Which money we are having? Follow from that, make a large one part, and that part you give to me because I am the oldest. I am the younger and I have those responsibility. I am oldest, so I want that large share of fortune. I want a lot of money from it. Then after that, when he heard this thing, he also said that, just only you are oldest. I am also old as if you. I am just nearly old like you, nearly old of you. Means I know that you are oldest. But if you are oldest, then I am also old just like you. I am nearly old of you. I am just only less than 1 year, right? Just I also want a big part of this amount. I also want a lot of money. Then these 2 brothers, they made 3 parts. One large part, the second large part, and one tiny small part of that fortune, of that money just only left. And after that, they called Chin, that Chin, come here. Now, we are oldest, so we have taken the large part of this money, of this fortune. Now, which left that you keep with you, that is your, okay? That you keep with you. Then Chin, he understood that this only one silver bag of coin just only left. This is so small in size and this is so small share of that money. But he didn't complain. He never made argument with his brother. So now here, wine. He never wine means complain. So what is the spelling of wine? W-H-I-N-E-D. And meaning of this word is complain. See the spelling of complain. C-O-M-P-L-A-I-N-E-D. Complain. He understood that they have taken the large part of the money. And just only they are offering me a one small bag with a silver coin. Not gold coins are there. Just only silver coins are there. So just only that much left with him. But he not whine, he not make any complaint, he did not make any argument with his brother. He said, okay, fine. But after that, these 2 brothers, Yong and Aim, now they are very greedy, they are very selfish. They just only think about themselves and which money they got. They just only invest that money to just only make their life better. That's it. They bought new furniture, they keep everything in that house. Even their house now full with the new furniture. This both brother, they spent money and they bought new furniture, new sofa, new cupboard, new TV. Everything was new. Everything. So their full house, that big house where they were living, that house full of new furniture. Again they called Chin. Now Chin had no space left there in that house to live. So they both brother called. And very rudely and arrogantly they said, now see, our house is full of our things now. Here is no that also the pigs so rudely with him, and they said that to go out of the house and now move out of the house because here is no space. We just only fill up this space with furniture which we now just only bought, so you have to move out this time also. Chin was so quiet by nature. He did not utter any single word. He just only said yes. He just only nodded his neck and he said yes. Why not? He take his clothes which he packed in an old cloth, and just only he had taken that and just only moved out. When he went out of the house, after that there was a question that where should I leave? Where Chin is going now, right? So after that, Chin bought a small hut. You know, a hut means very small. We know that different type of house. Some people, they who are very rich, they are living in bungalow, in big buildings, in a flat. But this Chin, he just only bought a little small hut, which is made of the grass. You know, now with the grass in a village, the people who are very poor or who are not having money, they are making that with the branches, with leaves and with the dry grass, they are preparing that hut. So he also bought one small hut in that same village, and he started to live like a poor person, but very happy. Huh? He never think about the money, that I want this money, I want to buy a new car, I want to buy new furniture. He never think about these things. He never want to spend money. He never need money for rest of his life. He don't want money every time. So he started to live very happily there in that small little hut. And here, these two brothers, Aang and Yong, they spend whole money. You know on which thing? They spend money to just only bought a sparkling jewelry. Then after that, they spend money to just only to bought a silk, you know, silk clothes, which is very costly. And they invest money on their house. They just only bought a new house, new clothes, new jewelry, new everything. They invest their money in that. But here, on the other side, Chin was so nice, you know. He spent that money. He not spent one single penny also on himself. Now, penny means what? A small British coin. We are living in India. We call 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 3 rupee. So, as in that, in a British, there is one small coin. They call it penny. So, here this Chin, he not even paid a single penny. He not spent on himself. You know what he done with that money? He spent that money, but not for himself. He just only bought some clothes and that he offered to a poor people. He bought food for poor people. And even he paid someone's rent also who cannot pay their rent. He also paid their rent. And after that, nothing left with him. Those silver coins, which is in one single bag, he spent that all money just only for the poor people. And nothing left with him. Now he was living in that small hut with the torn old clothes. That's it. But these two brothers, Aang and Yong, they were living in a big house with a jewelry, with new clothes, with everything. Now, after that, one day these two brothers, Aang and Yong, they saw there is one man in rags. In rags means very old torn clothes. They saw that this man was so poor. This man is so poor, and this man is just only wearing old and torn clothes. So they went near to that person, and that time they understood, this is our brother Chin. And they started to feel ashamed. They said that, we are belonging from rich family. Just look at yourself. You are wearing torn clothes. Please, means don't spoil our image. We are rich here. Look at us, how we are living here. And everyone, they know that you are my brother. So please leave now, go out of this village and don't come back here. You are too poor now. I don't want to spoil my image. So just go out of this village and never come back. Again, this Chin is so quiet and so humble and always following the instructions of elders. Now this time also he just only not neck. He just take only his old clothes and he went out of the village. So what happened with this scene after in the story, that you will understand. You will get the remaining story into the next video. Now thank you.